guys, I need to get a new, like, the thing that holds your phone on the dash, I need to get that. That's the next thing on my list, but I don't have it yet, so I'm going to keep putting this on my dashboard. And it's harder with my brand new truck because this thing's fucking huge, and the dash is larger, so I have to stick it in the corner where the clock is. Anyways, today is an arm day. I don't know if there's anything going on there, but the pump should be fucking sick because I took like a scoop and 75% of a second scoop. So hoping the pump is fucking crazy. My truck farts. Anyways, the tingles are already, they already had their peak. So the pre is completely ready to be utilized for destruction. I kind of had to sit here for a moment and just stare off into the void because the fucking tingles were about to kill me. It felt like torture. It felt like there was ants in my skin, you know, which there are, but I don't want to pull them out yet because I have to work out, right? And if I pull them out, the skin doesn't regrow. So, I tricked a friend into doing that. It was funny as fuck. Anyways, so today's arms, we're going to hit triceps, biceps, of course. No benching, of course. I'm not going to bench on that program that much anymore. I think it'll probably stagger down a bit. But, you know, I think if I keep benching, I'll be fine. I'll keep my strength at least, most of my strength. I mean, my strength's definitely gonna go down on this cut because I'm not fucking running anything. So it's obviously gonna go down. I don't wanna see that 225 incline go down though. That was fucking crazy. I can't believe I could do that. That was a PR for me. I've never hit 225 on incline before, and the fact I was able to do it for reps is fucking crazy. So I'm hoping that doesn't go down at all. So biceps, we're gonna hit some basic shit, probably some cable curls. We're gonna hit hammers, regular dumbbell bicep curl. Triceps is gonna be push down shit. I've also fallen in love with the like the dumbbell behind your arm, and you're just doing, or not your arm, your behind your head. And you're repping out those. I only use the fucking 25s or 30s, and that gets me for like 12 reps, and I'm not able to hit a 13th. So it goes fucking crazy. Sometimes I like to superset them with my rope push downs, but I'm not gonna do that today. The cut's been going good. Day two, almost day three. I'm fucking living with somebody is probably the worst experience, especially with a family member. I mean, of course, living with a family member who pays for your shit, that's fucking awesome, and I'm not ungrateful for it, but I pull up to my house and there's fucking a big ass Oreo package, fucking Little Debbie shit. So I had to just stare that stuff down, put it away. I couldn't submit. But this morning, I'll admit, I had a fucking 3 Oreos. But, of course, that's going in the calories. Hitting cardio here, they won't really matter. I think the daily calorie intake today was about 2,200. So I'm still going to drop weight. If not by a lot, it's definitely going to drop. Like, maybe by half a pound or so. I also checked my body mass index, or, you know, because they have that in the gym. And I think I lost the paper. It's in here somewhere. But I was at 164 pounds of lean body mass, which I think that's pretty good. I mean, for a fat ass like me, it's probably expected, but that is still like 160 pounds of pure muscle. So that's fucking crazy, right? Oh no, I gotta get that out. I think my body fat was like, probably about 100 pounds. About 100 pounds of body fat. But I'm going to be losing about 60 pounds of that, hopefully, and keep them the rest. Because I've seen fucking body mass percentages, and there's people with like 20% body mass, 20% body fat, and apparently that's not a lot of body fat, which I think is crazy because I thought I was 20% body fat. I forgot what percent body fat I was, probably about like 50 or some shit, but apparently 20 doesn't make you look that big. So we might just shoot for 20%. It's about shooting for the short-term goals instead of the long-term only, because the long-term is very demotivating sometimes. So you gotta have those little milestones that help you through the journey. So from the first video, no more mentions of Sam Sulik. I'm not gonna talk about him anymore, because, like, you know, that's just dick writing. And I've already made all my statements about it and everything. A lot of y'all in the comments in the past post were pretty supportive of it, so I thank y'all. But with all that out the way, it's not a late night gym sesh. I mean, it probably is for most people. It's about 10:30, but I wanted to wait later into the night because I don't like to record with all the fucking people here. Number one, it's kind of rude. Number two, it's a bit anxiety inducing. I mean, for a lot of people, yeah. For me, it used to not really be a big deal, but I stopped recording for a while, so I kind of lost that, I don't know what you would call it, shamelessness, I guess. And I've seen too many people in too many different comment sections saying, stop fucking recording in the gym, and you know, I completely agree with them. It's annoying as hell. So I don't like to record with a lot of people here. Because it's really just rude to record someone without their consent. I mean, unless it's someone being a dick. But these people aren't being dicks. They're trying to work out. So, if you're going to record in the gym, I suggest you wait until there's not that many people here. Or until, like, all the hardcore lifters go. Because they don't really care about being recorded most of the time. this weekend, I'm going to go to a different gym. I'm going to go to a more hardcore gym. And those are gonna be some less chill lifts, more so like Trend Twin type energy. So I'm looking forward to those. I'm working out with somebody else tomorrow. I'll get that recorded. This guy's an actual bodybuilder. He competed in the Teen Texas, I think when he was like fucking 14, and he got first place. So this dude has actually got a lot of good advice. It was the guy I was talking about yesterday. He got the free supplements from Redcon in his fucking car. So I need to hit him up too, because if I run out of this motherfucker, I need to try a brand new pre-workout, because I'm all about that diversity, right? Anyways, that's enough chit-chatting. We're going to go ahead and get the fucking workout, hit that shit as hard as we can. And that's pretty much it.
Okay, so we got everything. We got warmed up already. So we're going to go ahead and hit the working set. Using the 55s, hopefully I get a decent amount of reps with this. Ugh. So my lifts are basically the same. I'm gonna take a little bit of rest and then go for one more rep, maybe two. And I'm gonna take a 4:30, maybe 5-minute rest. Might decrease the weight on the next set. I wanna get about maybe 8 reps, 7 or 8. I don't know how many that was. All right, let's go for this. Yeah. All right. Let's bring down the weight. We're working with the 50s. All right. So, I got the fuzzy today. I hope that helps with the audio. But we'll see how that works. Whew, fuck. I think I need to go on a pre-detox. Caffeine. Because, not going to lie, every time I use that pre, my heart feels a bit funny. So, for the sake of my life, probably gonna detox from pre. So, that'll probably be tomorrow, maybe about a month or so. Just as long as it takes for my body to lose the resilience it has to pre. And then, so next time I take it, I can get to the point where I'm scratching my fucking face off from the itchiness. Here's fucked up. I was laying in bed before I came to work out, so. You dropped to 45. I've seen the bicep curls, two sets of that intensity. It's all you need, especially as a natty. I'm not going to recover that fast from these types of workouts, though. Four sets is bullshit. You don't need it. Well, I don't need it. It varies. I think especially with beginner lifters, you should probably be doing more sets because your body is not going to be used to the failure. You probably won't be able to achieve true failure. Because either you don't have the mindset or your body's just not built for it yet. But the four sets of 12, people demonize it so much, but it's still really good for people it actually works with or beginner lifters. I mean, for me, when I started lifting, I overworked the shit out of my body and I got really good results. I did three sets. But all three sets were supersets. And I only had like 2.5 minute rests in between them, 3 minute rests. Now, I wouldn't have done this if I started working out at an actual gym, but I started working out in my high school weight room during a class. So we only had like 55 minutes to work out. And that's not even the actual time because we would have to wait about 10 minutes to actually stop chilling in the basketball court and actually go to the weight room. So we didn't have that a lot of time. So I'd have to blast my body with a good workout, especially before breaks like Thanksgiving break or Christmas break. So, you know, coming here for the first time was a really big change because I actually thought supersets was how everyone worked out. So when I came here and tried to camp at fucking four machines for the entire workout, you could only imagine the surprise on my face whenever I saw people were constantly on the machines that I was using. And I didn't really bring a lot. I didn't bring bags or anything. I still don't bring bags. I don't see the need for them. Just get all your shit done before the workout. I mean, for some people it works. You got to bring a belt. You got to bring straps, whatever. I mean, I don't use that stuff. Probably not yet. I probably should to keep from injury. But
I just didn't bring bags. So I didn't really take up more than one machine with my equipment. I just took up one machine with a water bottle and my keys, and that was it. So the superset life for me is over, but I do the failure shit. But after my superset days, I did a lot of 4 sets, 3 sets of 12. I think sometimes I'll go to failure on some lifts, but not every lift was like that. And then I tried the Sam Sulik style of shoulders, where he did fucking 11 sets on lateral raises. I don't even know if he does that anymore. That was in his older videos. But that didn't really produce that much for me, because I'm not on shit. My body, I'd work out like 5-6 days a week, and my body was not recovering in time. So now my split really consists of a workout every other day. And after about 4 or 5 days, it's 2 consecutive days of working out. And then work out every other day. So today, tomorrow, it's consecutively working out. And then on Friday, it's not gonna hit a workout. Now my style for these changed. I like to do a heavy set and then work into, fuck, hold up. Okay, that feel weird. Single arm heavy set and then hit a double rep, whatever the fuck you call it. So we're gonna hit that. And then this will probably be the only dumbbell curl set I'll do. Okay, wait 10 seconds, hit a few more reps. I miss my carbs, honestly. I feel like I'm about to die. Might have overloaded on the pre, maybe. So this is probably my least favorite exercise in terms of risk, but probably my favorite in terms of the feeling I get. So it's a very unfair ratio in the risk to reward, but I feel like it really builds the peak of my bicep. So let's go get the dumbbell I'm going to use for it. Probably a 35 or a fucking, maybe a 30. And pump out some reps. I'm going to try to get this done as soon as possible because I got the tripod in the middle of the walkway. So I feel like an asshole. Let's test the waters here. See how the 40 feels. 35. Okay. 35 is even too heavy. I really hate this. But it's okay. Shh. So, before I get on the next side, I need y'all to give me any tips you have for evening out the strength in your arms. Like, this isn't even my main arm. This is my main arm. And I think I know why it's weaker, but I don't know if it's a form issue that I'm having on one side or something, or if it's just overall strength. But let's hit this again. I'm gonna go ahead and end this segment of the workout. We'll cut to the next exercise. All right, so we're doing another, whatever the works the peak, I think. I don't know what this works, but it's worked for me. I don't know how that works either. All right, so. No, drop the fucking weight. Holy shit. Damn. The weight on this arm.
Fuck.
Okay. That was a bit sloppy, I'm not gonna lie. Now is the beginning of the biceps. We're gonna go ahead, load up 150. I think that's, yeah, that's about, okay. I usually use the machine over there, so I'm making sure it's about equal to weight, because I'm only able to get like 6, maybe 7 reps out of this. So we're definitely gonna drop the weight. Okay. Yeah, that's about it. I don't know if the angle's good. I hope it is. Yeah.
Thirty.
That felt really good, actually. Okay. My tricep workouts aren't that hypertrophic. They're mostly built off of really high intensity. I only do like 6 or 7 reps for everything, and I drop the weight. Now, I don't know if I should be changing that up, because I feel like my triceps are really flat sometimes. Other times, I think like everybody else, they'd be like, damn, my triceps look so big. And then other days, you feel like you have the smallest ones in the room. All right, let's finish up the set. We'll do one more set of that. So I don't know if y'all can see. There's no fucking tips. Don't take any tips from me. But I flare my elbows out. I like to do that because it helps me feel the tricep way more. So that's why I do that. Most people like to have them to their sides. I feel it. But it's not really that much activation for me. So I prefer to flare them out. Of course, I keep my elbows in a stable position. Now, my tricep days, they're not really that hypertrophic because I don't want to overwork the muscle. That's probably not how it works at all because of my bench program. But I am going to switch it up a bit since I'm hopping off of that. So these will get way more hypertrophic, just not yet. We'll do the old tricep day, and then we'll probably switch it around next week. So, yeah. Any tips, please leave them in the fucking comments. I need so many, so many tips. Wait. All right. We're doing a bit of a speed posing session. Let's fuck up the lighting a little bit. Perfect. Alright, that's all we're going to do today. So I appreciate y'all watching the video. It was a bit of a short one, and I'm sorry for that, but next video will be way better. Maybe I'll upload one on Friday. I might not work out tomorrow, actually. So we're going to get a video in tomorrow, this one, and then Friday I'll work out. Get one up on Saturday. The Friday video will probably be a leg day or something. So without further ado, that's about it. That's all I got to talk about. Appreciate y'all watching, and I'll be back Saturday.